I know where we are. Parallax filed this building's plans with the city per regulation, and although they're clearly incomplete, these hallways have been mapped out rather well. It's a straight shot to the server core from here, more or less.
We've got activity. Looks like something's moving up ahead.
The building security VI must have noticed us. We'll have to make it past those ROMs without getting ourselves caught.
No problem. We've all got stunners, and we'll make those bots fry.
Well, is there another way? We don't have to destroy them completely, do we?
Not to put too fine a point on it, Turing, but they're not like you. They're just plastic and programming. Puppets.
But they won't always be. Not for much longer. Lexi, Decker, the truth is, we're planning to replace Big Blue with my original source code. Once we do that, we'll have the power to make every ROM a sapient individual, just like me. We aren't shutting down Big Blue, we're changing it. I know it seems like splitting hairs, but it seems wrong to destroy them when we've come here to give them life. They deserve it.
Oh, fine. Here, give me that stunner. Right? Done. I've changed the settings on it to give a lower yield with a more lengthy pulse. It should disrupt them long enough for us to get past and won't do any permanent damage to any systems that can't be repaired. Does that assuage your bleeding heart?
Yes. Thank you, Mr. Decker.
No problem. We can't all be soldiers.
Decker and I will keep our stunners at default settings so we can handle any humans that might show up. That low-powered pulse would just piss most people off, but wouldn't stop them. You'll have to take care of the shooting for now.
Lead the way. We're almost there. Malcolm Jr. model. They perform basic maintenance duties mostly. They're cute too.
Wait a second.
They're shooting at us!
Take it down!
We've got more of them!
Security once we get there. Too much risk in damaging the equipment that supports the racks.
Hey, you two. At this point, I think Lexi and I should hang back and guard the entrance, in case more security shows up. The alarm has been tripped, so backup is bound to arrive sooner rather than later.
Good idea. Neither of us know any of the technical stuff. We can hold our own against Christmas Eve level security.
Yeah, we'd be useless down there.
That works. We'll move as fast as we can, then. Be careful, you two.
Good luck up ahead. We'll catch up soon.
Come on, let's go! This should be the last hurdle before reaching Big Blue. The configuration ahead doesn't match the available floor plans for this section of the building. The path is blocked off. We can't go any further in this direction. Hold on for a moment. I'm going to tap into the maintenance mesh and see if I can find a way to open up this path. Got it. We should be able to move around freely enough using this. Do you mind opening the door in front of us? Good work. Let's head in. None of this is detailed in the public floor plans for the building. The mainframe seems to have been moved up a floor. Perhaps they installed extra heat exchangers in preparation for Big Blue going online. Oh, a call from... Lexi's transmission. She sounded so distressed. What could have happened? I can't reach her! All of this equipment's interference, combined with being underground, is deflecting most of the transmissions I would otherwise have the ability to receive. I agree. Perhaps we should hide first, though. If security got to her and Decker, they could be headed here next. If someone comes, we can hide amongst the heat exchangers until they pass. We'll just take a moment to assess the situation. The noise and mist from the climate control should mask our presence.
I'll switch to quiet mode on my interface for the duration. This way. Someone's coming. Hide!
Hello? Turing? Are you there? I need help. Out of her on my way out. They'll make a nice souvenir. I'm honestly surprised my gears still grind with how old some of my parts are. I could use it.
Decker is a combat android?
I know, what a pity. And then you decide to change our little plan here tonight. And now I have to clean up your mess before you make a bigger one. And I won't lie. I'm going to enjoy every minute of this. I'm not usually one for grand speeches. A combat android can only fill out paperwork for so many years before you begin to get thirsty. Theatrics are fun, but I like to get straight to the bloodshed. You know? So let's do this the hard way. I like the hard way. I love the hard way. Lucky for you, your cop friend fried my cloaking emitter with her stunner before she ran off. But really, that's better. See, now you have hope you can win. I can't wait to watch it drain from your eyes as I wear your entrails like a scarf. Won't this just be the most fun? Let's make it even better. To your advantage, there's a lot of electromagnetic radiation, noise, and weird thermal currents in this room. It actually makes things almost fair. Almost. And now? Now the fun begins. So here's how this is going to work. On my turn, I'm going to tell you a story. I'm going to tell you every minuscule detail about how I've stalked you this entire time and have been ahead of you every step of the way. On your turn, you're going to run, maybe hide, perhaps a little of both. Doesn't matter. Player's choice. Lucky you. Just keep in mind, if I manage to scare you or piss you off really bad, I might be able to hear you breathing deeper. Your heartbeat is like sonar to me. The louder it pounds, the faster I race to stop it. Heck, I might even be able to smell you if the currents in the air are just right. So that's the game. Won't this be fun?
This is bad. What do? We can't fight him! Wait, we have the... No, he messed with our zapper. We can't take him with these settings, and there's no time for me to figure out how to revert it. We also don't have much firepower left. We only have the charge left for 4 stun level shots, at most. It'll have to be enough. Let me see. The interface I'm using allows me to control whether these surrounding server columns are active or not. If I close off some nodes, it should at least slow his movement and disorient him. It won't stop him outright, but... I can focus on tracking Decker's location using this, and you just tell me where to block off his path so we can try to navigate him away from us. Don't try to trap him. He might get more angry. Just have him to avoid us until we think up some sort of solution. If he finds us, be ready to shoot.
Ready or not, here I come.
You take the lead. Pick where to close first, then let's get moving.
Bye.
Yeah.
So here's how this is going to work. On my turn, I'm going to tell you on your turn. Doesn't matter. Just keep in mind, your heartbeat is like, heck, I might even be able to. So that's the game.
This is bad. What do we do? Wait, we have the... No. We also don't have... It'll have to be enough. Let me see. If I close off some notes, I can focus on tracking Decker's... Don't try to trap him. He might... If he finds us...
Ready or not.
You take the lead. Pick where to close first, then let's get moving.
So let's see, where do I start? I suppose the old man is a good enough place as any. He honestly thinks he's some kind of modern Machiavelli, but to be frank, he hasn't been on much of a winning streak lately. Parallax used him as a scapegoat for that big ROM database hack back in 54. They even got him to resign as CTO just to powder their own noses. And as soon as he did, they stabbed him in the back and voted him off the board the very next day. Even I'll admit, that's cold. Since then, he's been licking his wounds, waiting for the chance to get revenge, to get back where he feels he belongs. I dug through dirt for years with him, looking for a way to blackmail Parallax so that he could make his way back into the elite. So imagine our surprise when one of our informants inside Parallax tells us of this brand new Big Blue project. The perfect opportunity, but we had to act immediately. And then, you walk in right through the front door of Hayden, the only person with the ability to take advantage of Big Blue, who's just mysteriously gone missing. I was going to dump your body in the bay, but Fairlight figured it might pay off if we give you a little lead, and waited to see what you could track down. Find us another way. And boy, did it ever.
Okay, let's move.
Thank you.
keep our distance. We're not even hurting him.
Suppose I should tell you how impressive Hayden's little creations. Oh, except he's dead, so I guess it doesn't matter. But without you, we wouldn't have our path to Big Blue, the gold mine. Of course, Fairlight would prefer to not tank Parallax stock to the shitter, but this is too good of an opportunity to pass up. As soon as I'm done playing with you two, I'm going to trash this entire server complex. That'll wreck tomorrow's launch, but only temporarily.
Let's move!
Did you know? I wasn't even planning to kill you until a few minutes ago, when Turing just had to spill the beans on your idea of turning all ROM sapient. That can't happen. Big Blue relies on ROMs being easy to control and patch. Your plan is a little more permanent. Fairlight needs a way back in, but he wants that power. By the time Big Blue is ready to come back online, Fairlight will be back in control, and it'll launch under his administration. With Big Blue, he'll have access to every ROM on the planet, and that's what he's always been after.
Let's move!